We've been talking about using contour lines to plot functions of several variables and how the contours are related to the gradients. Now we're going to take what we've learned about calculus and apply it to hiking. If you've ever gone hiking in the national parks, you've probably gotten a map that looks something like this. It's called a topographic map, or a topo map for short, and it shows the elevations of every point along here. So every point along this line, the thick line, is elevation 9800. The next thick line is 10,000. The next one is 10,002, 10,004, 10,006. These are the maroon bells near Aspen, Colorado. So you can see a bunch of features. First of all, if you're moving along a contour map, a contour line, you're not going uphill or downhill. You're going perpendicular to the gradient. The gradient points straight uphill. Now you see over here, you've got a whole bunch of lines packed together. You gain 400 feet in a very short distance. That means it's very steep. The gradient is big. Down here, the lines are widely spaced. The gradient is much smaller. That's what you expect. Near the lake, it's kind of flat. The contour lines are far apart. Near a cliff, the gradient lines, the contour lines are very close together, and the gradient is big. The next feature that you'll notice, if you want to draw the gradient here, the gradient is pointing up towards the high country. Over here it's pointing the other way. And of course, the lake is at the bottom. The gradient is pointing away from the lake because the lake is at the lowest point. That's where the water's collecting. Now, I said that when the contour lines are close together, you have a cliff. I'm going to show you this on another map. This is a map in Oregon, of the Columbia River Gorge and some of the waterfalls there. So, look at the contour lines along here. They're very, very, very closely spaced. There's basically a cliff that the creek goes to the cliff and plunges over the cliff. The gradient is pointing this way. Actually, it's very big and pointing that way. And when you have the lines very close together, it means it's very, very steep. Now, another feature you notice here is along the creek, the contour lines are bent. They're sort of forming an arrow. And they always point uphill along a creek. The reason is that if you're on a creek, if you're in a creek bed, there are two ways to go uphill. You can move away from the creek to one side or the other, or you can go upstream, and they're all uphill. So to one side is uphill, to the other side is uphill, upstream is uphill, so there's the contour line loops around and points uphill. So whenever you get a creek or a river, you tend to get contour lines that are deformed. You see them over here with Waukema Creek, that the lines are going up and then back down, up and then back down, up and then back down, and it points upstream. Now the next thing we're going to look at is what things look like near a mountain peak. Near a mountain peak, let's zoom in a little bit. There you go. At the top of Tom-like Mountain, you see the contour lines are going around and around. And around. They kind of circle the peak. That's the sort of the signature of a peak. The highest point is here, and then this is a little bit lower, and this is a little bit lower, and this is a little bit lower. But something interesting is happening here. there's another peak nearby, which has its own circles. What happens when you get to the saddle point between two peaks? Actually, I think I found a better one than that. Not seeing it right now. When you get a saddle between two peaks, I'll draw this on paper. The blue is supposed to be the contour lines near two peaks. So you have a peak over here, and you have another peak down here. And there are the contour lines near the one peak, and when you're sitting at the saddle, first of all, it's flat. The contour lines are not all that close together. But you go downhill, the ridge is running between the peaks like this, and whichever way you go on that ridge, you're going uphill. So this is higher than this. You're going up, 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 up. And in the other direction, you're going up, 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 up. Whenever you go away from the ridge, you go down, 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 down. So whenever you see this sort of shape, that's what a saddle looks like. This sort of shape is what a peak looks like, or what a valley looks like. Unless you have the numbers, you can't tell whether this is the lowest spot and you're climbing out of the valley, or if this is the highest spot and you're climbing and you're falling away from the peak. Okay, so the basic principles of how to read a topo map. The lines are contours. The gradient is always perpendicular to the level sets. The contours are level sets. The gradient is perpendicular. It points uphill. The closer the lines are, the steeper the hill. If you have a bunch of lines that are really, really closely connected, you're at the edge of a cliff. If you have a mountain peak, it tends to look like this red figure. If you have a saddle, the contour lines tend to look like this. And whenever you have a creek, if the blue is the creek itself, your contour lines tend to form this V shape, and they always point upstream. And that's how to read a contour map using calculus. How to read a topo map using calculus.